chilly December afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Cincinnati Bengals. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. To speak of, call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. They run the option on second down. Mahomes gets it out quickly, and it's complete out wide. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Catch number 44 of all the year. It's a first down. Zero hesitation that time. That was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to him.
Mahomes quickly complete out wide, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. That was a lightning fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately, so he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
Mahomes firing complete, and he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. The catch and run there, good for 16 in the first.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field, but at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. Now they try the right side here. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Now a handoff looking right, trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Raiders call on a nickel set for 3rd down. Now they try the right side here. And he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he needed. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. First carry for Raheem Mostert. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. A big play that time for the Raiders. 59 yards for him on the ground.
First down.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. There's Mostert. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
The ball carrier.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
On second down, Mostert. He's going to get four out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
Mostert, the ball.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
On third down, Bridgewater. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down well short of the first at about the 9-yard line. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
That ties
so a return of serve, so to speak, here on the second drive of our game as they respond to that opening field goal with three of their own.
I like that. Going a little tennis on me.
I know you. You like to mix it up with sports.
That. They crack a forehand back out, and we get a backhand. What was the serve? What was the return?
It was a backhand. Really good backhand.
It's a nice top spin on the
a little bit.
I love it. Almost a mirror image when you really get down to it. I thought that was pretty good stuff.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Now a handoff looking right. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Quickly completed to the right flat. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 39. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
That's the
3-3, a tight one after one on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 39-yard line.
56.
Easy.
56. Check pass. 56, the mark, boys. 56.
Easy.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The end result, 21 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
They go play action here on first down. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
To me, there's nothing like watching rookie effort in the NFL. So excited to be there. They're going to give you the max on each and every play, aren't they?
Well, he proved himself on that catch, that's for sure.
I think he may have proved himself to the point where he's going to get a second here.
It'll be a three-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there, but of course you're going to give it to him.
Second and goal, they'll give it to him again. And he gets halfway home from the four down to the two-yard line.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone trying his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
They'll try to run this one in. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
And Gay knocks this one through. And the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. So we're trading first half field goals. No breakthrough on the touchdown front. We've got a 6-3 game.
Yeah, and I know so many people look at a game through offensive eyes, right? They want to see how the game's played that way. You know how I'm going to view it, right? The defenses, to me, have responded well in this game. Like what I'm seeing from them, both of them hoping to keep it to field goals and not give up big touchdowns.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easy.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They're in a 13-3 hole here now as they come up on first down. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle. It's tight end. And that'll bring up second down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Here's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Give him 30 yards there.
Still all sorts of time left in this game, and you'd like to be able to say take it one play at a time. But the truth is, they're probably going to have to hit on a few big plays in the passing game to close this gap, and that's a good start right there.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown.
Complete to
John Hightower. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders are back within a score. They haven't fully climbed the mountain, but they've started the ascent here with that score.
I like that, right? I think they've left base camp now, okay? So they've started to move their way up the mountain. Long way to go, but at least they know it's manageable.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out-and-out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
First down.
And we've hit the 2 minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
In second and eight.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Let's go. Be tight.
Yellow.
Jack. Jack. Jack.
Mahomes now to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, three interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
24-yard line.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. John Hightower with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And once again, the Raiders are back out in front. That could be an important swing right there. A touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
At their own 29-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And he'll give it here to his running back. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
They just keep trying, but so far, finding no room for him to run.
None whatsoever. In fact, you run the numbers. He's under 3 yards a carry at the moment. Call on a nickel set here for 3rd down. One more time, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Shot before the half from Mahomes. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. The Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
Play action now, Bridgewater. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 36 yards on the play.
They came out with an aggressive mindset to start the third quarter, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them take more of these type of deep shots as this game moves along. They connected there. They expect to connect on more before this one's over.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. Here's Bridgewater, and they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And down inside the 15 he goes. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. To the running game with Mostert. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
1 yard gain brings up 2nd and 9.
They'll stay on the ground with Mostert. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. Call it an 8-yard gain, much better shape now on 3rd and just a yard.
And it's 3rd down.
They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the 1st down as he's tackled at the 2. They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
On second and goal, they'll give it to him again. And this time, he is in.
Yes.
A great effort there. With a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Point after, right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to 11. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing. And try and get back to where you were to start the half.
So one play and they're already just shy of midfield. Here's Mahomes to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A big play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals have got it back to a one-score game. Gay is on for the point after. Is down to 4.
Is good. Makes the score Raiders 24, Bengals 20.
Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. 3rd and 6. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first. First and 10, Bridgewater. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy, but it's going to be second down. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield.
Bridgewater's.
That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And it brings up
Bridgewater on 3rd and 2. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A little surprise pays off on third and one. Pass instead of run. Gets him 15 yards. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. This is Mostert. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And just a yard to go here on second down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Raiders add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Set to kick off.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. That'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Gain of a yard.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
They'll go again with Lindsey.
Phillip.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Hey, check right and three. Six, back six. Get the ball. Mike six. Mike. Hey, 57, 57, Collins.
They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. And that is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake, Bridgewater. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. And that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had six last week. And this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out. They'll try to increase the pressure.
They go play action. Bridgewater. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Long for Bridgewater. The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. Brian Burns racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long. Why are you calling play action?
Because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack. The Bengals drive about to get going. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. Well, that'll help the old passing stats. Remember, it was a pop pass, so it's not a wide receiver run there, Charles.
I like the way that you scored it, and that's exactly how it goes into the books. But remember, he's had success throwing the ball the standard way in this game. And here, this little tap pass, it goes for good yardage, a little something extra in his repertoire.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Mahomes going to throw, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of four, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
Third and 11.
Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
The extra extra point up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive.
Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and 7 at the 28-yard line.
Now here's Mahomes. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked up by Jesse Bates.
Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the 2-minute warning, and we'll be back. Third and long now after the sack, and we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. From the gun. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to take another shot here. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Back to the air on second down. It's Mahomes. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. And it looks like this will be the last play before the 2-minute warning. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And now here is another interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Raekwon McMillan. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
At the 43-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he will be out of bounds. A good yardage there, and he'll get a second to catch his breath as it leads us right into the 2-minute warning. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown.
To George Kittle.
George Kittle, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys. do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Now they try the right side here. Jesse Bates made the tackle from his safety spot. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
A gain of four. It's now second and six.
To throw, it's Mahomes. And he's got him. Got his man on the end route. Complete.
That's good.
Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout, as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Now a handoff looking right. And this time they were waiting for him, as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now they try the right side here. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. On play action, it's Mahomes. And he's got his man on the out route. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. And on third and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. Now Mahomes, and that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. From 6 yards away, and the Bengals are able to cut into this lead.
On for the point after.
No surprise there. Third and goal down here. That's where they're going to look for their tight end.
Yeah, you want that big guy running his routes, because it doesn't matter who they cover him with. If it's another big guy, he might use his bulk against him. If it's a shorter defender, might go over the top. Either way, you tend to find a little bit of a mismatch in that area.
And it's the Raiders that'll come up with it. And that will put victory in sight for the silver and black. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on, into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down.
First down, Las Vegas.
He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy. That'll bring up second down.
At the 25-yard line.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. That is caught inside the 5. And and he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
So Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Las Vegas, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Meanwhile, for the Bengals, they fall to 6-6 now on the campaign. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland to take on the Browns.